Hi friends, welcome back to Star Laboratory.
Star Laboratory provides latest laboratory practical videos for you.
If you are not a subscriber, first of all, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell button.
Okay, today we are going to discuss about the blood cell component separations in the blood bank system. Now let's see what is the principle behind these blood component separations. As we all know, the blood is the major important fluid in the human body and it is made up of various components. Different components in the blood vary in specific gravity. So this factor is used in the preparation of the blood components. So by differential centrifuging, the blood components can separate from whole blood more efficiently. So there are some special conditions for the storing as well as in the separation. So those things we can discuss later. Then now let's see what are the advantages of these blood cell component separations. So first one, only the necessary components can be transfused to the patient. So this can avoid overloading of the circulatory system of the patient. Then the second one, from one blood packet, several patients can be treated. Then the third one, total expense of the unit of a blood can be shared through several patients. Then the disadvantages, as the equipments are very expensive, when preparing components, initial expenses are very high. For example, we are using several equipments like a plasma extractor, cold centrifuge, laboratory refrigerator and etc. Then the second thing is, for each and every component, special storing conditions should be supplied. Then the third thing, if accidentally any infectious agent is presented in the whole blood packet, it can transmit to several patients. Then now let's see what are the blood cell components that can be separated from a whole blood packet. So this whole blood should be collected in a CPDA anticoagulated blood bags, that means citrate, phosphate, dextrose, adenine solution. So this whole blood, there are two types of major components are there. So first one, cellular components, and the other one is the plasma components. Then if we take the cellular components, there are three types as we all know. So first one is the red cell components. So under these red cell components, we may able to prepare packed cell red blood cells, then leukocyte poor red blood cells, then the third one is the host red blood cells, then the other one is the WBC concentrate, then the platelet concentrate. Then if we take the plasma components, we may able to prepare FFP, that means fresh frozen plasma. Then the second one is the stored plasma, then cryoprecipitate and cryosupernatant. So this is my small introduction regarding these cell component separations in these blood bank serology systems. So the next time we will discuss in details about the storing conditions, about the separations, centrifugations and other procedures, explanations, principles and several things we will discuss. That's all for today friends, so thanks for watching. After watching this video, please give a like, leave your comments and share it. If you are not a subscriber, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.